On the first Fab Scraps Technique Tuesday, I have a fun embossing technique with a stencil for you. Hi, Gerry here from Gerry's Craft Room and welcome to my channel. The Fab Scraps stencils are a bit thicker than most stencils and are great for embossing too. You will need an A4 size die cutting or embossing machine, and you need the sandwich that you use for embossing dies. But first I will tell you how it works, so it's easier to understand how you get the right impression. With embossing comes some sort of rubber mat. This mat is slightly too thick for running through the machine, so when it gets in the machine between the rollers and the pressure gets on the rubber, it's pressed flat and wants to go somewhere, and it will be pushed in the spaces of the stencil, which gives you an embossed paper. Now I have a big shot and I will show you my sandwich. Check your own machine for the right sandwich, but it will work in the same way. And the easiest to show you an embossed or debossed impression is with words, because when you do it different, you'll get a mirror image. Here you can see I have embossing and debossing of the coffee bird stencil. First I show the embossing. I have the embossing plate, then the rubber mat, on top of that the cardstock, and then the stencil on the card, in a way that you can read it. Basically, with all stencils and words, you must be able to read it. We call this a little donkey bridge in Dutch, and it's a way to remember. And then on top the cutting plate, and then it's ready to run through the machine. If you want a print on a part of the card, just put the plate or rubber mat up to where you want the impression, like I show you here. Now most cardstock has a smooth side and some sort of structure, and when you know how to do it, you can choose where you want your embossing. And of course this also goes for patterned paper. And now the debossing. I have the embossing plate and rubber mat still in place. The stencil goes under the paper this time, and because it's easier to see where it goes, I flip the stencil and the paper around and put it on the rubber mat. The cutting plate on top again, and it's ready to run through the machine. You see how easy it is to get these lovely embossed impressions with a stencil. And here's how I use the stencil on a card. You know those people who love coffee? What do they always want? They want more coffee, so I have coffee words inside. I hope you like this technique and will give it a try. Love to hear from you in the comments. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching!